So this is my homemade hand engraving machine, which I've just brought back into service. And on it, I've got the dog foot pedal. And over there, I've hooked up the M audio pedal so that it controls the strike rate. So if I turn that up, you can hear the motor running there. And this here is my super easy graver controller, and I'm using this foot pedal here to control the power. And over there, there's a Hall effect switch, foot pedal, which controls the strike rate. So we're gonna have these two in a head-to-head. There's been a few questions really about what the performance is like on the super easy graver. So I've concocted a little test here today to see if I can answer those questions. So I've got a piece of stainless steel here. This is 304. I've just got a sheet, and it's 30 millimeters square, and there's some lines on that are roughly 3 millimeters apart. And I've got my homemade hand engraving machine, Sean Hughes version, here, which I've got a 10 millimeter ball bearing. That's quite a heavy ball bearing, that in there. And I restrict the length of stroke in that with various different springs. What it could do is with is a screw in the back here, in much the same way as I did the original the brass handpiece on that, just to make that a little bit more adjustable. And I can put in the various tools for that. So I'll be using that. I've hooked that up to a foot pedal, and I'll show you that. I've got the Mark II handpiece here for the super easy graver. You might notice there's some glue around here. I ordered up two originally, and I dropped one of them, and it snapped off here. So I've just bumped some glue around there just so that it strengthens that. The drawings that are on GitHub do have a little fillet in the corner there, and a tapered barrel on the outside, just to strengthen that. The reason why it's weaker than the Mark I is that obviously the hole in the middle is bigger. I think that was a Homer Simpson moment there. Right, so we've got stainless steel, and I've also sharpened up a couple of 2 millimeter carbide rods here for this. The type of carbide that I've used is Klot. They were cheap enough off the internet somewhere. Right, first up we have the super easy graver. I find it difficult to get my hand on here. So this is on maximum power. Carbide graver. And this at all, I'm just letting this take its own time.
So this is a much heavier hit. Yeah, I think the tip's gone. Much deeper cut. So the angle of that is a 120. You can see that that's a heavier cut than this one up the top here. So this is a super easy graver. On maximum power, maximum stroke length, and this is stainless 304. So each of these, the width of these lines is about a touch over 3 millimeters. Give you an idea of scale. I'm not really that bothered whether these line up, because that wasn't the object of doing this. That one's pretty crappy. It's just to show how these cut. It was well and truly gone on that. I've taken the power down to 75%, and we'll see what this is like on here. Had to have a good old go to get through that. Just see it, that's in focus. Not very good on that. So it's a little bit of trouble getting through it. At 75%, but it just gives me a bit more control. 75%, and go ploughing through and take me off somewhere. Went a bit deep there. Lost a bit of control. There we go. So I'll put this back up to 100 for this bit, because we want to take out a chunk out of here. That's quite hard work. Try not to push. Oop. There we go. better to do this in a couple of goes rather than try and plow through it in one. You've got stuck there. Just gradually ease it out. That was a bit better. Just took it a bit easier, didn't go quite so deep. So this is the Homemade Hand Engraving machine, and it's the same tool. I just swapped them between the two different hand pieces. Yeah, I can push. I've deliberately done that harder. I can push a lot more power through this handle. So I get a much deeper cut. You wouldn't necessarily want to do that on something like this, but it's just showing you what it can actually do. I think these lines are a much better thickness here for this particular size of piece. If I wanted to go with less power on the I would have to put a longer spring in. I could just ease off on the strike rate, because reducing the strike rate on the Homemade Hand Engraver does reduce the amount of power that's going through the handpiece, so you do have some control over that. I don't think one is better than the other. I think it's just different, and you get used to whatever you happen to be working with. I've got more control over this than the super easy graver. It could be because I was doing a shallower curve on those other ones. It's quite nice. Oh, there's a big chunk come off that tool there. There's sort of a lag there on the homemade hand engraver. Starts off and then it eases off and then it comes back in more powerful. There we go. Slight difference in stars, these ones not quite so shallow as these ones, but other than that there's not an awful lot of difference between them. Okay, well, we're back on with the super easy graver, and I've changed this tool so that it's a 98 degree tool, and I've taken it down to 60%, and I've just wound the handle in so it's a slightly shorter length of stroke here. I think I'm going to have to go a bit heavier than that. Yeah, I don't think I've got, oh, the tip's gone. All right. I haven't sharpened this tool very well. I'm going to have to resharpen this. That's really quite fine shading there, but the tool is shite. Here we go. So I've got a better angle on this now. It's a 98. I cut it with the wrong profile to start off with. I did a 115 and it should have been 120. just taking that up to 75 there. Oh, that was a up and down there. I just took it a bit too fast, I think. That's better. Most of this you won't even see. A bit deep there. Right, we're back on with the homemade engraving machine here. I've put a longer spring in, so we should be hitting a little bit lighter. See how we get on with this. Same tool. Like the tip's gone there already. See the microscope moving there? That's the wind on the outside of the garage. Very windy today. This is really nice and smooth, the homemade hand engraving machine. I do like the way the shading, that it starts off soft and then gradually increases the power as you accelerate the way. The only problem I have with the handpiece is the pneumatic hose that comes out of it is a bit stiff. rushing it a bit, not taking me time as much, so it's not quite, it's not as precise. That's one very good. The tip's really gone there quite badly. So there you go. Not sure that you can actually see much difference between them. I'm damn sure I can't. Definitely not from the naked eye. So they're different. Is any one better than the other? Oh, I don't know about that. Both of them were fairly straightforward to use there today. And that's the only disappointing thing, is how poorly the carbide performed. So that could be how I've got how I sharpen the points, but yeah, I don't know. Anyway, I probably won't be doing any stainless steel again, because I've got no reason to. Hope this has been useful.